Good morning, my dear student. Today I am going to teach maths, standard 8, first chapter. This chapter one, rational number. In a previous video, was already I have told about the number system, the basic part about the number system. Now I am going to elaborate on rational number. First of all, what is rational number? Any number which can be represented in the form of p by q, and p and q belongs to integer, and q not equal to 0 is known as rational number. Now, for example, 2 by 3, minus 5 by 3, 4 by minus 6, minus 23 by 7, etc. Now, if you see here, 2 by 3, that is in the form of p by q. 2 is also an integer, 3 is also an integer, therefore, p and q both belongs to integer, and q not equal to 0, which is the denominator part, it is 3, that is not equal to 0, that means it is also an rational number. Similarly, minus 5 by 3, 4 by minus 6, minus 23 by 7, these all are rational number. Now, few properties of rational number. First of all, closure property. A closure property means if you add two rational numbers, the answer also will be a rational number. And rational belongs to rational. Second is commutative property. Commutative property means if you add two rational numbers, you can interchange and the result will be the same. That is P by Q plus R by S equal to R by S plus P by Q. Next is associative property. Now, P by Q plus bracket R plus S plus P plus U bracket close is equal to P by Q plus R plus R by S bracket close plus P by U. So these are the three properties you can learn about: rational number, closure property, commutative property, and associative property.
Now I am going to solve few sum from exercise 1.1. The first question is question number 1, subpart 1, add the following: 4 by 7 and 5 by 7. And if you see here, 4 by 7 and 5 by 7, if you see in this case, the denominators are same. So when denominators are same, you have to just take LCM of both, that is 7 only, and you have to add the numerator, that is 4 plus 5, that is equal to 9 by 7. Next I am going to solve question number 2, subpart 1, that is 5 by 11 plus 4 3 by 9. Now in this case, now one is proper fraction and the other one is a mixed fraction. So first you have to change the mixed fraction in the form of improper fraction. So it will be 5 by 11 plus 4 9 is 36 plus 3, that is 39 by 9. And then you have to take LCM of 11 and 9. That means you have to multiply, since there are no common factors between them, it is equal to 99. So the down you will write 99, and first you have to divide in the denominator and to multiply with the numerator. So 99 divided by 11 is 9, 9 into 5, that is 9 into 5, this is the first one. The second is 99 you have to divide by 9, that is 11, now 11 into 39, 9 5 are 45 plus 11 into 39 is equal to 429 by 99, that is 474 by 99. This is your answer. The next question is question number 41, finding the additive inverse of 2 by minus 3. Now first of all, what is additive inverse? Now additive inverse means, suppose the rational number p by q, its additive inverse will be minus p by q. It simply means that any rational number by what you should add so that the sum is equal to 0. And that is just, that is p by q plus, if you add the additive inverse of that, it will be equal to 0. So in this case, 2 by minus 3, the additive inverse will be minus 2 by minus 3. That is, minus minus will become plus, that is 2 by 3. Next question is, Question number 5, 1. X equal to 10 by 13. You have to verify that minus minus x is equal to x. So in this case, left hand side LHS, that is minus minus x, that is minus minus 10 by 13. Minus into minus is plus 10 by 13. That is equal to right hand side. Therefore, LHS is equal to RHS. Is equal to 10 by 13. Hence, verified. I am going to solve question number 6. Using appropriate property of addition, find the following. The question is 4 by 5 plus 11 by 7 plus minus 7 by 5 plus minus 2 by 7. Now, first of all, if you see the question, two kinds of fractions are there. In this case, in two of the fraction the denominator is 5, and in two of the fraction the denominator is 7. So first of all, you have to arrange the like fraction in one side, that is 4 by 5 plus minus 7 by 5 plus 11 by 7 plus minus 2 by 7. This both you keep in bracket and these two you keep in bracket. Now in this case, the LCM will be 5, that is 4 plus minus 7. Here also LCM will be 7, 11 plus minus 2, that is 4 plus minus 7, that is plus into minus is minus, 4 minus 7 by 5 plus 11 plus into minus is minus, 11 minus 2 by 7. 4 minus 7 is your minus 3 by 5 plus 11 minus 2 is 9 by 7. Next you have to find the LCM of 5 and 7, that is 7, 5 is your 35. You have to divide this with the denominator and multiply with the numerator. 35 divided by 5 is 7, 7 into minus 3 is minus 21, plus 35 divided by 7 is 5, 5 into 9 is 45. Now 21 minus 21 plus 45, that is 45 minus 21, that is plus 24, that is 24 by 35. This is your answer.